Dear students, welcome back to my channel. Today, we are going to discuss about one of the essential elements which makes life possible on the earth. You are very well aware that life exists on the earth due to the presence of land, air, and water. In this video, I am going to explain air, its importance, and composition in detail. Our earth is surrounded by a huge blanket of air called atmosphere. It is attached to the earth's surface by gravitational force. Let us know what makes it essential for our survival. First one is, it provides us the air we breathe. Second, it prevents the sun's harmful ultraviolet rays. And the third one is, it acts as a blanket of protection. Without this, we would be baked alive by the heat of the sun during day and get frozen during night. Thus, you can say, it is this mass of air that has made the temperature of the earth livable. Do you know, the air we take in while breathing is actually a mixture of gases, water vapor, dust particles, and smoke. The two main gases present in the atmosphere are nitrogen and oxygen. The other gases present in the atmosphere are carbon dioxide, helium, ozone, argon, hydrogen, etc. The lower layer of the atmosphere contains water vapor and dust particles. That was all about composition of the atmosphere. Let us know about the three important gases in the atmosphere. First one is nitrogen. It makes up 78% of the total volume of the atmosphere. Nitrogen is a very important gas. When we inhale, we take some amount of nitrogen into our lungs and exhale it. Nitrogen is also required by plants for growth. But plants are not able to absorb nitrogen directly from the air. Bacteria in the soil absorb the nitrogen and change its form so that plants can use it. Atmospheric nitrogen is also used to manufacture chemical fertilizers. Clear? Now come to the next one, that is oxygen. Oxygen makes up 21% of the atmosphere. It is the most important gas. All living organisms need it to survive. They breathe oxygen present in the air. During photosynthesis, green plants absorb carbon dioxide and release oxygen. This process helps to maintain the level of oxygen in the air. If we cut trees, then this balance gets disturbed. Hence, it is our responsibility to plant more and more trees rather than destroying them. Now come to the third important gas, that is carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is another important gas. Green plants use carbon dioxide to make their food and release oxygen, whereas humans or animals release carbon dioxide. The amount of carbon dioxide released by humans and animals seems to be equal to the amount used by the plants, which make a perfect balance. Carbon dioxide released in the atmosphere creates a greenhouse effect by trapping the heat radiated from the earth. It is therefore called a greenhouse gas, and without it, the earth would have been too cold to live in. However, burning of coal, smoke from vehicles, factories, etc., increase the amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. The increased carbon dioxide absorbs more heat and increase the Earth's temperature. This increase in the Earth's temperature is known as global warming. Let us know, how does it affect weather and climate of any area? You would be amazed to know that this rise in temperature causes the snow in the coldest parts of the world to melt. As a result, the sea level rises, causing floods in the coastal areas. There may be drastic changes in the climate of a place, leading to extinction of some plants and animals in the long run. I hope this is clear to you. So children, let us end today's class here. In the next video, we will continue with the structure of the atmosphere. Do subscribe my channel and get notifications about upcoming videos. Thank you everyone.